Good luck with the Switch version.
I recommend. I mean, it's fucking better in the DS version. At least you don't have to pass the fuck or whatever the fuck the system was. I just got it described to me. It's like, oh boy, that sounds like a bit of a mess. That was actually a deal breaker for a lot of people.
Because that mechanic. I remember that we did kind of play a little bit. And,
yeah.
I was like, what the fuck? How do you...
Oh, the one you know, you know. The yeah. big issue at this point is mostly, we started the recording, but the big issue at this point is mostly the fact that it's like, well, yeah, the Switch motion controller is a little bit janky. Because, you know, motion controls. So, all right. Back to it.
All right, back to it.
Just now, we went to the ADDC.
And just now, the Lord and Prince play Judgment with me, your Lord.
And the Lord with my own eyes.
Has started again.
And?
Oh, hey!
There's no chance you walk. You're practically a lost cause.
I heard your voice in New York lately.
Yagami-sensei, is that what you think?
It's Yuri!
Oh!
It's like this.
Right!
It's your own fault!
You tell me you're innocent, and I'll fight to the end. I really have nothing to lose by helping you out. It's just like I told you. Whoever did it is framing me.
You know, feels like the whole thing would have been a lot easier now if we did not have that flashback, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's like
on the day of the crime.
And also your voice by Yuri Lowenthal, I will believe you. It's,
yeah, no, exactly.
It's bullshit. Like,
shit.
You can't have Yuri Lowenthal's voice. I will trust you.
Yes.
Fuck.
Nobody would dispute that.
And after that, you covered Wakusan's nose and mouth, suffocated him, and then carted him out in the lawn.
On this channel, we've...
That's not true.
We've heard your Lowenthal quite a bit.
Wakusan wasn't there when I went into his room.
Yeah.
I
didn't see him at all that day.
You were going to go back to Spider-Man 2? A lot of Yuri.
So when we went down to leave the center at 10 a.m. after gathering the linens, we realized there was a body in the truck.
I mean, hey.
That's what happened.
Be more open about it. That's not
then,
you
after
safe
debating
it,
whether or not to report
situation.
The body, you chose to hide it in the mountains.
It's beautiful. That's gonna be... Well, the line in his eyes kind of made it for a weird... It's gonna be a huge hurdle to climb the trial.
I had a criminal assault on my record. I knew the police would have suspected me if I went to them.
Yeah,
aren't you forgetting the bad blood you had with
like,
Wakusan?
In any society, but in Japan, it's also really
bad.
Like,
blood.
Oh yeah, you have criminal record.
3 days before the murder,
always a monster.
Wakusan claimed Okumokun
I mean,
here.
You gotta remember that's my favorite thing of like playing Persona 5. It's like, all right, answer a question correctly. Wow, I guess he's not that bad. I guess he's not just some weird crazy dude who just stabs people at random. It's like, it's been a whole year. Really, guys?
Yeah, no, that one...
Really?
That one always gets me. It's like,
please?
Still? Are we still on that?
My parents never call me.
About it at the center.
So,
when did you even ask?
While you were busy chatting up Terasawa-chan. Even if I bitch about it, I'm still damn good at my job.
You have a shitty attitude,
well,
but you do know the
you
job.
Take his wallet,
least,
or...
You know.
Not quite. They call it delusion of theft. It's a symptom of dementia.
Oh, okay.
You think something's been
good.
Stolen
okay.
from you, then blame the first person you see. Not the easiest thing to deal with.
I can
right?
imagine.
Someone accuses you of theft for no reason? Must have been a shock. So when Wakusan tried to hit you, you just about hit him back.
But I didn't hit him.
Oh, no.
No.
He did the Yuri thing.
I murdered him.
I wouldn't kill a man over
God, no,
something
he's doing
like
the Yuri whimpering.
No!
I can't!
Not the shaky voice!
Come on, Okubo-kun.
Not shaky Yuri.
You got a record of violence.
Shaky Lowenthal! No, stop!
It wasn't me. I swear. Somebody set me up. Please, you have to believe me. Whoever did this is laughing at all of us right now.
Calm down.
I was doing the panicky Lowenthal.
Yagami-sensei. Do you believe me?
I do.
As long as it's not a guilty Lowenthal.
Okay. And next time, come along.
Fine. I can take a hint. You and Yagami-sensei can cuddle up all you
ah,
want.
Ah, that's a Yari Lowenthal.
Hey. You know that nurse, Terasawa-san? Cute girl. It sounded like she was worried about you. That you'd have a chance with her.
No!
He's trying to, trying to be like, hey, come on, something to look forward to. Get a little bit of hopes. Yeah. Like, well, that didn't work.
Honey.
Fucking whoops.
Yeah.
Maybe I didn't think that one through.
So Shintani just left you hanging, huh? He's got to learn some damn patience.
I hope he didn't just take the car and left.
Pull it. He's not kill you.
Pull a key. Yeah, no, I was going to say, pull a key to you.
That scene will never not be like, okay, hold on. Someone did not think about that detail with the director of the scene. I'm like, you're just going to leave and take the fucking car away. Nishiki is stuck in the mountains.
Where's this coming from?
To be fair, you know what?
I suggest you be more assertive.
Right. Mm-hmm. Okay.
That was a little weird.
Yeah, what the fuck was that?
I was supposed to be a...
Said he'd have been nicer to
It's actually not the first time I've seen animation in this franchise. Like, but yeah, that's what it's supposed to be.
Oh.
Yeah, it's
okay,
supposed to be a tiny
it just looked like him... It looked like... It just looked like his model being reset.
Yeah. Many times. In 1 second. But yeah. What was I talking about? I forget. Anyway. Oh, yeah. It's like, you know what, though?
Why can't you leave?
Yeah, I guess that's not the point. I was not paying
attention. Oh, you have to talk to...
Like, so to finish what I want to say, it's like, you know what? The guy did intend to kind of shoot me to just free me of my suffering. I think the least I could do is probably just take his car and leave him in the mountains, I guess. I can
Mafia
maybe understand that part.
Prosecutor, right? Isn't it kind of taboo for her to date a defense attorney?
Can we not do this?
Either way, guess the Okubo case comes first. Pleading innocent, yeah?
That's the plan.
What is your plan here? This isn't going to be an easy win.
Well, I'm working on that. There's one piece of evidence that still bothers me.
Yeah? And what's that?
What should I focus on if I want to prove Okubo innocent? Oh, we have to retroactively do the... Okay, you know what? How about we... Laundry car used to collect the bed sheets, large enough to hide a person inside. Many people witnessed Okubo pushing said car in the morning while it disappeared from his hospital room. Well, it's not gonna be that. After the investigation, police found trace of the victim's bodily fluids in Okubo's truck bed. Subsequently, an input of the fluid belonged to Wakum. Such evidence suggests that Okubo was behind a murder. Not that either. Yeah. Panoramic view of the hospital room where an elderly patient stayed for 2 years. However, he suddenly disappeared from the hospital, was found buried in the mountains of Okubo. Well, that doesn't mean
anything.
Literally
doing anything. Neither with a win.
So I think I was like, yeah, my...
It's probably the hallway.
Take that!
Take a look at this. It's the hospital room the victim was staying in. This is the last place Waku-san was seen before he disappeared. At the time, the witness would have seen Waku-san from this angle through the window in the door. But the cabinet here would have been blocking his face.
Uh-huh.
In other words, there's room to argue that the witness never actually saw Waku-san to begin with.
Ah.
It might have just looked like there was somebody in there. Or maybe
the killer
set it up
really
to
like...
look that way.
And how would that impact the trial?
Well, the premise that the victim was still alive at 8 o'clock would no longer be on the table. Meaning, the crime could have occurred during a much wider time range.
Oh.
With that in mind, we could claim there's no proof...
There's also the aspect you gotta remember that most of the time, like, especially something
right.
In terms of defense attorneys,
not
like...
Bad. What the hell's your problem?
Okay, if we can just say that's like, well, maybe there's not enough... grounds to actually like continue the trial right now. Like already it's like, well, okay, you've done your job.
Yeah.
So there is also that aspect. They're able to prove that there may be some evidence might not be
that
actually
that,
you know.
I think so.
Get back here.
What the fuck?
He's being murdered again in the past. What?
That bastard. Oh, eavesdropping on you.
What the hell?
I tried to stop him, but pull a stun gun on me.
Well, Shintani, I appreciate that. Thank you. Legit.
Hey. Wait up.
Hey.
Wow.
He does it too.
Even back then. All right. The chase begins.
Hold up.
But at least Shintani, at least, you know, that's where the professionalism comes in, because it's just like, hey, someone's just fucking eavesdropping on you. Fuck up, what are you doing here? So thank you for that. I appreciate it. I'll get you.
I'm gonna get you.
Oh wow, that person just passes through the fence between them, but I have to go around them.
Yeah, no, of course.
That's bulky and muscular. You know, Yagami. Okay, I'm gonna cut the corner.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Nice!
That was so unnecessary, but okay.
Oh, really, huh? You're close.
Fucking spinning around kick, let's go.
Oh, they're gonna pull their stun guns out. What? Terasawa?
Help! Someone help me!
Aren't you Terasawa-san?
Let me go!
Uh-oh.
We got a groper out here? Scum of the earth! Not on my watch, you
well,
son
for
of a
once,
bitch.
For once, that's actually like, you know what? I appreciate you guys actually like being active on that. But unfortunately, you could not have picked the
worst time to come
yep.
in.
Also, yeah, I have very basic move because of
yeah,
course.
No, I was gonna say like you.
Hold on, by the power of the law,
you're under arrest. Oh wait, no, I'm not a cop.
Well, I mean, there's no better way of arresting someone than having them just knock unconscious, I guess. Sorry, miss. I'll be right back.
At this point, I don't know if she's gonna stay. I almost feel like by the time you're done...
I am the law!
I feel like by the time you're done with the fight, like, she'll be long. And it's just like, where the fuck did she go?
Hey, come over here. Hold on. Yeah, okay.
Ah!
Go over here.
Still jump off walls.
BAM!
Nice. Oh, you didn't get anything out of it.
I am Dulu. Oh, super attracted to... Wow, she's a trouble magnet. Look at that. She went right in there. You could not have made those moves in that fucking suit. I refuse.
Yes, that's what I was thinking.
I mean, the tight jeans are already...
Can all lawyers fight like that?
Only the cool ones. Yeah, fair. Fair. There's a
yeah.
lot of questions.
Like, first of all, shut the fuck up. I don't want to hear you talk right now. Second, you're coming with me. I'm asking you some goddamn questions.
Did
and
you
third,
really need to
we'll
run away
talk.
Like that?
So...
I assume you came to see me.
There was something I wanted to talk to you about, yes. But I wasn't sure if I should. Then that pig-headed friend of yours started shouting, so I just lost it.
Okay, but did you have to tase him? Not that he didn't have it coming.
I see you're practicing your Saitama
anyway,
cosplay.
I'm listening if you want to talk.
Nice.
No matter what it is, I'll keep your secret. Anything you tell me will fall under client-attorney privilege.
Could be dangerous.
Well, you know the witness who last saw Waku-san? Said he saw him sleeping in his bed.
Uh-huh.
Well, that witness is a man by the name of Shono-san. He's one of the scientists at the ADDC. Not only that, but he's the director's right-hand man, too.
Huh. Wow, everybody's got like...
Oh,
that's him! Pretty much your run-of-the-mill researcher.
Yes. He's a very dedicated doctor, so the nurses have a lot of faith in him.
Even though he forgets to tell his face
but
about it.
Something
but, you know.
Felt off when I heard what he had to say about the incident.
And what's that?
I mean, I suppose if you do good, it doesn't fucking matter what face you have.
I guess I'm just skeptical as to whether or not he actually saw Waku-san. I don't think he's intentionally deceiving us, but he may be mistaken somehow. And if I had to guess, I'd say the other nurses feel the same.
Still, why hasn't anyone mentioned this until now?
How could we? Nurses talking about a doctor behind
happens
his back.
More than you think.
That's not something a nurse could do without consequences. And if it
yeah,
came to a courtroom testimony...
Why. Obviously.
None of you would testify?
Maybe the other nurses wouldn't, but I would. I never really fit in over there anyway. Besides,
you're gonna fit in very nice in a coffin.
I think Okubo-san is innocent.
Oh, really? Sounds like I've finally got an ally on my team.
I thought I was alone there.
Fucking finally.
Oh, we won't regret this.
Immediately dies in... as soon as he shakes his hand.
The touch of death.
I'm currently employed as
my god, even sounds like he's
the Advanced Drug Development Center. Part of our research consists of clinical tests.
To be fair, he is also involved in the general ward of the director in the current day.
On the day of the crime,
you can see that's okay. Well, he's also heavily involved in that whole like drug thing. So you know what? Again, I could easily believe that if that dude is just in a constant mood of stress, fair.
What time was that?
Yeah. Probably very
7:50. You're sure? Yes.
Journalist
guy there. Eat breakfast at
well, he did say he was there during the.
Yeah, I always head to the break room.
Continuity.
Myself,
yeah.
Right around then.
Not the rat, the weasel. Right, the rat is. This
break room, to be precise.
The rat is a police officer.
That's correct.
What's his name? I already forgot.
Our more mobile patients walk there for breakfast instead of eating
he's
in their
rat,
own rooms.
The journalist is the weasel.
Then, while the nurses help the patients eat, I ask about how they feel and how the medicine is treating them.
And on the day of Wakusan's disappearance, you passed by his room before going to the break room?
Yes.
And in that room, you saw Wakusan lying on the bed?
Yes.
Can you describe the situation to us as you remember it?
You know, this franchise
the door has a window,
putting the budget on
so
people talking,
you can see into the
a
room
courtroom
from the
setting is absolutely
place.
Fucking
and
perfect
this is the
for
room
that.
You're referring to, yes?
Because it's
that's
just
correct.
People, like, this is the
from
most basic shit we're seeing.
Hallway,
like, this is...
I could see Wakusan lying
they're just good
bed.
At it. It's,
he
it's
was
great.
Asleep, with a blanket covering most of his body.
And what time was that?
Around 7:50.
No further questions.
Yagami-sensei. Why did you call her
she's
to
the only other ally you fucking
she
have,
actually
so
asked
honestly,
to testify. Is that a problem?
Not really, no.
Here's my chance for a comeback.
You have to believe in me, Lowenthal. Alright.
Terasawa-san, you were present for Shono-san's testimony just now, yes?
Yes.
And what is your opinion on that testimony?
He's a bitch! Not what
for
I asked.
A scientist. I felt his wording was rather imprecise. And as a medical professional, I felt his
okay,
actions
that's a bit
were
more
negligent.
Ooh, direct than I thought.
Could I ask you to be a little more specific?
Our witness, Shono-san, claims he saw Waku-san sleeping in his bed during his morning rounds. However, there's no way he could have known that just by looking in from the hallway.
Man, I really don't need this right now.
I have evidence supporting Terasawa-san's testimony.
Yeah, I don't think it's related to this.
Shino shouldn't have been able to see Waku. I have evidence to prove that.
I don't know why we're even...
Yeah, no, at this point, we know.
Please look at this.
Take that! Sorry.
It's a photograph of the victim's room as viewed from the hallway. In other words, this is what Shono-san would have seen when he checked in on Waku-san.
And this evidence points to this fact. Shono's testimony was a lie.
I mean, I feel like maybe it's like, okay, maybe mistaken, but I mean...
Shono-san was lying when he said he saw Waku-san in the
bed. He saw someone.
Excuse me? What he saw from the door was likely nothing more than a bulge of sheets. He couldn't have been able to identify it specifically
unless,
as
Waku-san. Some reason, he was sleeping the
so
other
so to claim as much in his testimony seems like quite an exaggeration, don't you think?
But common sense would dictate otherwise, would it not? Who would be in the bed other than Waku-san?
The staff nurses are trained to always enter a room when checking in on
a patient.
I guess
doctor
in Waku-san's
would know
case,
that.
It's impossible to tell anything just by looking in
yeah,
from the hallway.
She doesn't like him at all.
There was
yeah,
actually
no.
one time a while back where we thought he was under the covers, only to find Waku-san eating in the break room
oh,
a second later.
Oh, there's precedence.
And upon re-examining the room, we realized that we had mistaken a bunched up pillow
fuck,
for
fuck, there's actually precedence.
The witness makes an important distinction. The prosecution asserts that Shono-san's testimony is clear. that the victim was taken out of his room at some point between 7:50 and 8:30 in the morning. They claim that because of this time frame, the defendant must have smuggled Wakusan's body out in his laundry bin.
That's why Okubo-kun was assumed to be the only person who could have killed Wakusan.
But if Shono-san's testimony is invalid, the defense asserts, we have to consider the possibility
that
Wakusan was taken in the middle of the night and nobody else was around.
That's my end.
After which, the killer could have waited until the morning to plant the body in the defendant's truck. In other words, the defense establishes that there is reasonable doubt that Okubo-san is the killer, rendering the prosecution's central argument unsound. Your Honor, taking this new testimony into account, I'd like to call Shono-san back to the stand for cross-examination.
With that alone, he would have succeeded at his job.
Yeah.
That alone, it's like, well, okay, you kind of did your job.
Shono-san.
That's a huge move.
It might not help for your job later if you have to continue with that, but like, you have done your job there.
Let's see how Shono responds with that evidence and Terasawa-san's testimony out in the open.
Sorry.
I'll get right to the point. On the day of the crime, what did you see when you looked into Wakusan's room?
I saw Wakusan asleep in his bed, I think.
And did you get a clear look at his face?
It feels like this has the sound that should come out of his mouth.
I don't remember.
So it's possible that it could have been someone other than Wakusan in that bed. Or maybe even a pillow that you mistook to be Wakusan's body.
Oh, jeez.
Isn't that right?
Objection! The defense is leading the witness.
Sustained. Please rephrase the question.
See what I mean? Like, there's such, like...
Shono-san, can you say without a doubt that Wakusan was in that
bed? Like, only this fucking franchise could do that.
I don't think I can.
Courtroom scene.
Then the defense rests. But I do have a quick remark for the prosecution.
Oh.
Huh?
The prosecution's argument has fallen apart. Now to go in for the kill.
The charges against my client stem from your assertion that he's the only possible suspect, assuming the crime took place within the stated time frame. However, the defense has proven without a doubt that Shono-san's testimony is unreliable, establishing reasonable doubt for my client. I would suggest
that you
withdraw the charges against my client. With such inconclusive evidence, you'll only be wasting the court.
That's the lawyer way of saying it. Yeah, okay.
The prosecution does not consider the witness's testimony inconclusive. His memory of the incident may be fuzzy, yes, but that doesn't change that he saw the victim.
So, your whole case is based on a fuzzy memory? This promising young man's future is at stake, and you're willing to throw that away on unreliable testimony?
I hate the use of
Dr.
promising
Shono
young
is
man.
A bright and diligent researcher.
Yeah.
After watching his own grandmother
and I feel like
dementia,
it's very like
he vowed to create a drug that could cure the disease.
Very purposeful.
After paying his own way through
term.
Medical school,
yeah.
He went on to become the head researcher at the ADDC. Day after day, Dr. Shono visits his sick patients out of the kindness of his heart, leading to his valiant testimony
here
today. If you want to know whether I trust this man, then my answer is a resounding yes.
In other words, because he's such a great researcher, his testimony is infallible.
Am I crazy?
His own admission
like,
that he's not sure is somehow
we...
overlooked? Is that the sum
is
of
that
it?
Is that just me, or maybe that's me misunderstanding
because
how that works?
Because from here, it sounds like you're putting your faith
like
in Shono-san's title,
these
not
two
his
are
testimony
just
today.
Going at a catfight against each other.
The prosecution is not as easily swayed
as they have their dicks out,
think.
They are measuring.
And
okay.
You want to talk
all
reputation?
Right,
what of your client's history of domestic
there
abuse?
There we go.
Oh, he's gonna bring up Okubo's record.
Fuck.
6 years ago, the defendant broke his girlfriend's finger. The poor girl is still suffering from the effects. And the cause? A minor, drunken disagreement.
I don't sound like Sasuke!
A few days prior to the crime, Wakusan, suspecting the defendant
of
stealing his wallet, lashed out and punched
and
the defendant
I'm amazing.
In the face. Given the clearly violent nature of Okubo-san here, that alone would be motivation enough to murder the poor old...
No problem. Okay, she just got up for some reason.
Oh. Can she do that?
Is something wrong, ma'am?
Apparently not.
Please remain seated.
He's just like, ma'am, please. Uh-oh. Oh, no, she brought in the budget.
Oh, this is one we can't skip.
Terasawa-san?
You okay?
Okubo-san is not a violent person.
Oh.
hasn't even had a drink in over 6 years. Not a single drop since the incident.
My court will not stand for this commotion.
He didn't blame Waku-san at all. He knew that the outburst was just because of his dementia. That it was all the sickness's fault. So there was no reason for him to resort to murder.
Terasawa-san, kind of. Please.
Okubo-san really is an incredible, caring person.
Please leave this courtroom at once.
You're right that he may be hard to approach, but he's a kind soul, and he always keeps his promises. Okubo-san's not the only person in this courtroom who would be affected by a guilty verdict, either. As a matter of fact, it would break my heart.
Aww.
And even through it all, he wanted me to keep this a secret, not to tell anyone, not even his lawyer, that we were dating.
Fuck. She's the girlfriend?
Yeah.
She's the one who got the finger broken?
No.
Oh, okay.
Even though he knew he could have ended up in prison.
But like, sure, honestly, to have her on the side like of the investigation would have helped a lot, but he didn't even want to.
But when the prosecution is
probably because
criminal,
of, you know, how people with criminal records are fucking treated.
Yeah.
Like, wouldn't want people to know that you're associated with me.
Her little outburst wasn't technically admissible, but as the trial dragged on, it hung over the jury like a stone.
Yeah, that's the weird part that is like.
And in the end, Shinpei Okubo was found not guilty. But only a month after his release, everything changed.
Why?
Yeah.
The same girl who had so bravely proclaimed Okubo's innocence died by the man's own hand.
But now there is something a little weird about this where it's like, wait, hold on, so your legendary victory came from something that was not even technically admissible? That's a little weird. But anyway.
Yeah.
But oh well. Look, it's also the fucking, like, drama, so you know.
Yeah.
Gotta put a little bit of.
Something wrong?
My brain went somewhere else for a little bit.
But.
Hello.
I haven't seen you in about 3 years, Kido-san. I see you're still the director.
You look familiar, but I can't quite place the name. I seem to recall.
Okay, well then you fucking shut up. Fuck you.
I'm a detective.
You fucking know. Fuck you.
The name's Yagami.
Ah, I remember now. You're the reason Terasawa-kun's no longer with us. Remember, Shono?
Why'd you have to involve me in this, sir?
Okubo-san was unstoppable. If only my testimony had been.
Man, you look like a beaten dog. What? This is insane.
Yeah, no, really.
It's so fucking.
What brings you here anyway?
I'm investigating a murder, and I'll need your cooperation with it.
I'm sure it's also gonna go super well.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Nothing wrong is gonna happen.
I will have full cooperation.
Yes, I see. Yes.
Man, what a long fucking flashback that was.
Yeah, no, really.
It's insane.
It does seem we received a phone call from this Shintani-san you speak of.
Do you know who he was calling?
Dr. Shona.
The same Shono-san you were just with?
Okay. Why?
Yes. However, it's unclear as to what the point of the call was meant to be.
Yeah, I mean, understand. Well, I have no fucking idea why that would even be a thing.
Shintani-san didn't leave a message.
Ah.
You have no idea what he wanted to talk about?
None. Shono says he doesn't know a Shintani-san. And sees no reason why
that makes sense. If he was looking into.
Oh, really?
Shono and I co-authored the research paper.
I paused a lot to talk about this stuff because I don't want to talk over them, but.
No, that's fair.
It is true at the same time. It's like, well, okay, the only link that we have is actually with Shintani's death.
Yeah.
So, what's any link prior to that?
Yeah, no, that does complicate things a lot.
We're quite well known, as it turns out. Sometimes
like we have a
complete
link
strangers
to that,
pretend to be close friends or relatives
in
order to contact us. Perhaps Shintani-san fell into that category.
Have you heard of the mole murders taking place in Kamurocho, Dr. Kido?
Three. Is that what they call me?
Each one with their eyes gouged out. It's a
crazy
business.
Easiest fucking job ever.
Killed in the same way.
I've seen the news.
Well, they can't.
Can you think of anything tying the ABC to those murders? Dead, I guess,
but... Huh? Look, just what are you implying? Look, I believe we're done here. There's nothing I can help you with.
It was a little heavy.
Please stop!
It was a little heavy-handed, I'll admit. Fuck you, Mercer. You? I mean, Kuroiwa.
Detective Kuroiwa, Kamuro Police, organized crime. One of your guests here has information related to the case I'm currently investigating.
Fuck.
What do you mean?
Well,
that would be you, Yagami. I'd like to speak to you as a material witness to the murder of the lawyer Masamichi Shintani.
Is that so?
Oh boy, man, this is okay. Oh, we're going to new chapter.
Yeah. Here goes fucking nothing.
The mole's latest victim was the lawyer, Shintani. The last call he made brings the case that ruined Yagami 3 years ago back to the surface.
Good way to summarize this in one sentence.
The patient was taken from the hospital and found buried in the mountains. Yagami defended the suspect, Shinpei Okubo, and got an acquittal.
Yes, it's all right.
But one month later, he murdered his girlfriend, Emi Terasawa, with a kitchen knife and burned the remains.
Does he have to look so evil here?
I mean, it's really Lowenthal. Of course it does.
Yeah.
Of course he does. When it's crazy Lowenthal, he needs to look as insane as humanly possible.
I'd like to speak to you as a material witness to the murder of the lawyer, Masamichi Shintani.
Is that so?
What timing, huh?
I'm Hoshino, an attorney at Genda Law Office.
Listen.
Officer, is this
interview
voluntary?
I get it, but there is just something that... It would look so much better if you didn't always have that fucking backpack.
It's your call, Yagami-san.
I think I'll pass.
Excuse me?
You have your answer, sir. You can go now.
You can make this easier if you come now. Next time, it won't be voluntary.
Your empty threats don't mean much to a lawyer.
Yeah, I was about to say, like, why are we doing this in my office?
Too bad he's not a lawyer anymore, then. Your friend's nothing.
Ooh, wow! Bitch!
Just come along quietly. I'll come back with a warrant.
A lot of this thing of, like, okay, dickish attitude, but aside from that, unfortunately.
I'd like to see you try. Why do you suspect me, anyway? I bet you don't even have a reason.
I can come up with a few good ones.
Enough! Get the hell out of my office.
All of you!
There's a lot of, like...
You'll regret this, Yagami.
There's a lot of this...
Kuroiwa-san.
There is definitely the mix of professional and also something very personal.
You two, out.
Before we go, can we speak to Shona-san for a sec? We need to know why Shintani called him.
Listen, I already told you he doesn't know. Get it through your skull. Now, please leave.
No problem. We'll
let you get back. Unfortunately, not much we can do at that point.
Yeah. Except bust through the security breach.
Fuck yeah.
Woo!
Gauntlet.
This is really hospital
gauntlet.
I mean, I really feel like that's where it's heading.
I can't believe that detective thinks you're a material
witness.
I thought
for sure Shino was just going to trip on that lady.
I don't know
what
he's talking
about.
Me too.
What I'm more interested in is...
I mean, he got close earlier.
Yeah.
When he got stuck
in
the chairs.
That's a good point. How would the police know we were here?
Beats me. For now, let's
focus
on Shona. It would be a waste coming here and not talking to
him. The Yakuza again?
Agreed. Let's see if the receptionist can help us.
Our receptionist, son. Let's
be real. The Hamura seems to have ears and eyes and ears like fucking everywhere.
Oh shit! Hold on. What was it that was available there?
Not in the special. That's for sure. All
right, it was the esoteric knowledge, but
you wanted the dodge roll.
The quick step strike is definitely a good one.
And knock down
the patient. They're all good though.
Yeah. Well, we can.
I can put a few, I guess.
Yeah.
Wait, that got me a new skill.
Which is it?
Blessing of the Thunder God. Quick step backwards and press triangle at low health.
Well,
being stunned by enemy attacks.
We could get that one because we can also get knockdown evasion as well, or reverse slash reversal.
I could get the two actually.
Yeah.
While falling, you can get back up.
There we go.
Or I can attack. There we go. Nailed it. I guess we should see. That's gonna be the end of that episode.
Yeah, fair enough.
All right, man.
Whew.
A lot.
A lot.
A lot.
Holy shit, a lot.
And all this, the fact that, you know, this entire fucking flashback to lead to, and 1 month later.
That's. Yeah.
Whew.
Yeah, no, that's the part that hurts the most.
What it does do really well, though, is that, yeah, I understand why Yagami is at the point he is in his life now.
Yeah.
That's...
That hurts.
That, yeah.
That hurts a lot. And I mean, I get why he decided that he was no longer eligible to be a lawyer.
Damn you, whiny Lowenthal. Hi, so everyone, I'm your lord.
And I'm the court wizard.
And thank you all for watching. Hopefully I will have more puns. We'll see. So until next time, that's an order for me. You take care of yourselves. See ya.